Another full build before your eyes. This one, a brand new kit from Revell, Germany in 1/24th scale, 184 parts, Land Rover Series 3 long wheelbase station wagon. Yes, all the way from across the pond. These are out right now. The Revell Germany kits are out right now. Let's get a bunch of plastic out here because this thing's got a lot to go through. All molded in gray. There is no chrome in the kit whatsoever. Check out that nice grill with that crosshatch on it. We've got mirror options, literally three mirror options. Three. We've got a roof rack, super fine molded. We've got steering and sway bar components. I'm sure I'll call some things the wrong name, which makes people happy when they can point out when you make a mistake. We got engine halves, beautifully molded engine there. Easily assembled. Of course, being an all-modern kit, I do expect this to go together very easily. We will find out what the fit and finish is like in just a little bit. Let's get out even more styrene trees. We're not even close to being done. We've got a lot of plastic in this kit. We got a full one-piece frame. Thank you, Revell, for doing that. Multi-piece frames are a recipe for disaster if you make one little mistake. You have to be very careful. This one will ease everyone's lives. We've got hoses and lines and connections. Look how fine those windshield wiper blades are. Pedals we've got. We got everything you could think of on the real one has been duplicated, and we just don't have to add oil to it. We've got our drivetrain, heavy-duty leaf springs. Look at the pumpkin cover on that thing, all the multiple drive shafts, the steering wheel. We got our shocks and our springs built as one, which I don't think I've ever seen before. We've got our transmission transfer case. We've got an exhaust system here, full exhaust. Now you can build this up, of course, however you want. It's your kit. We've got our large interior floor pan, which will go right onto that frame. You can see the nice 2019 trademark, which was when I'm building it. I'm planning on this video coming out after Christmas when everyone's stuffed full and playing with their gifts. You can take your gift card and go to modelroundup.com and get this on pre-order, so when it hits, you can get it immediately. Radiator, pulley and belt system, oil pan, excellent, very, very fine molding. Exactly what we expect from modern kits. Check out those wheels, molded open. You can see the light go through them. We got our nice one-piece roof there. We've got our fan, even the detail on that battery, phenomenal. We've got our other sets of wheels molded open like they should be. What else we got going on here? We've got our front windshield. We've got our interior, looks like the firewall there. Nice. We got our hood, even with its little clasps and hinges. Full underhood detail. Muy superb. Here's our interior panels. Door panels look great. Should be easy enough to mask those off and black them out once we do the body color. I was going to do a little rust effects on this, but I was told that they have aluminum body panels, so that kind of shoots that. But we can still do effects with it if we want. We got different body panels. We're getting into transmission. We got, look at those little handles. Oh, we got seats here. We've got center consoles for left or right-hand drive. We've got dashboard for left or right-hand drive. We've got more of our seat backs and different seat options in there. All kinds of options along there. And we've got that gorgeous one-piece Land Rover body, which will make, I thought this might come in multiple pieces, being in one of these Revell boxes that's kind of narrow. But nope, the whole body fell out. I was super happy about that. So we'll be able to get that worked on. Check out the beautiful detail on that. No flash, no mold overs. We've got a lot of holes defined that we can drill out for different models. All different kinds of models, and the instruction manual will tell us, based on what we're building, where to drill our holes and when to drill them so that they are perfectly placed. Let's switch to the other side of the table. We've got one. We've got two clear parts trees with many small parts on it. We've got five off-road tires, and we've got a set of decals, mostly with just interior and under hood items. Looks like the backs of the mirrors there. Then there is a massive assortment of license plates for whatever country you'd like to have it from. Even has Nevada license plates on there. The tires look nice. I don't see a name brand on them. I am looking closely. They look like black walls to me. We have nice tread detail, aggressive off-road tires, like they should be on a Land Rover. And then we've got our clear parts trees. Very nice crystal clear glazing. Feel free to do your effects to that. And we have the rear glazing as well. Even has the smaller windows or the smaller pieces of glass. Everything that should be on the real one is on the kit. I'm going to soak the parts in some simple green. Let's do some sub-assemblies next. Look at all those parts. Now, before you have a Canary and you think, there's no way I'm buying that kit, man. There's so many parts to work on. It actually is much simpler than it looks laid out in front of you like this. And let me explain, okay? First, we'll look at some of the assemblies. We've got our chassis all done. All in one large assembly, we can do that in one color and then weather it up from there. That goes on really nice. The axles mount on to solid points on the frame, and then our springs mount over the top, and everything lines up and key locks together. So you are all set that way, and it is a beautiful assembly without any worries. You can see perfectly square. You don't have to worry about your wheels being cattywampus. I also like the very, very big wheel attachment points, those large lugs instead of teeny tiny little pins. We've got our engine and transmission assembled, transfer case down there. Take a look at all the detail on that little beauty. Try not to cover it up, turn this around, but we've got all kinds of hoses and lines and everything. So we're going to get to paint this up one main color, and then I can go ahead and detail that per my wishes with a paintbrush. You won't have any problem. You've got a very nice assembly. Let's get the body out of the way. The body doesn't need any work on it except for holes drilled depending on right or left-hand drive. Decide right away whether you want to do right or left-hand drive, and then go into your manual so you don't make mistakes over and over. And in the manual, they will have LHD and RHD for left and right-hand drive. Go ahead, cross out the sections you won't be using, and when you do that in advance, then you'll be all set to go. So just drill out your holes for your mirrors, for your side marker, for your mirrors there. You have the option of putting mirrors on the fenders for another version. I went with the version that comes out. All the holes have little sink marks for you in them, so you can begin working on them, but that's all we needed to do with the body. On the roof, we'd have to drill out numerous holes. If you want to use the roof rack, you don't have to. If we want to use the skylights and mount the spare tire on the roof, I want to do all of the above. So we've got that all set, and this will just be painted all one color with the wheel and its lugs that mount on the roof, so we're all set there. A lot of these little trees you're seeing, which make it look like there's a gajillion parts, is all stuff that's actually going to be painted black. Belt and pulley system, radiator and shroud, airlines, hoses, small attachments, these are all painted black, so that's why they're, I cut all the individual trees so I can mount them in my grips. We've got antennas, we've got little parking brake levers, stuff like that. That's all painted black. There's no chrome or super detailing. Drive shafts, steering wheel, license plate frame, that's all painted black. So that's why these are all cut free from the larger trees, so that I can get stuff painted up individually. And as I show them to you and say, you know, we're going to be painting this, you can see the parts just start to disappear off the table really quick. So don't worry about it. Now, these seats I'm not using. I'm actually using these three here. But everything on this tree gets painted black. The windshield wipers, the shifter, the four-wheel drive shift lever, the air hose, all that stuff, the parking brake lever, all gets painted basic black. So I will just paint it all on one tree, cut off what I need, either save the seats or recycle them if I need to. We've got our exhaust system all together. You can see that it seems nice. It will be, it is tricky to thread this through the chassis once we're done, but you'll be able to do it. So do know that you can assemble that whole sub-assembly there. We've got our dashboard and our under panel for the dashboard and our pedals and our steering column all together. This is all one black unit. So I'll be able to clamp that and paint that all up and assemble that with the vehicle. We've got our beautiful battery. We've got some little straps here. Those are all painted black. Again, same as these little handles and the gear shift lever. So I'm just leaving those on their little trees so I can paint them, including this little dongle, and I forget what it was for again, but I left it on there so I could actually get it painted instead of trying to hand paint it on the car because it's so small. Well, the reservoir bottles, stuff like that. So we've got all that little stuff on the side. We'll get some more sub-assemblies out here. Everything here, the windshield frame, the firewall for behind the dash, and the hood all get painted body color. So why not leave them all on the same tree? Cut off as much of the tree as I could around the hood and stuff so that the attachment points that I do have to remove are easy enough to do and it's not a problem. On the interior, you will decide whether you want right or left-hand drive immediately so that you glue it in the appropriate place and you get the appropriate doghouse with the gear shift and everything on the correct side all set up for you. And then you will drill out the holes depending on the rear seats you want to use, if you want to use any, and the other rear seats mount back here. Speaking of the rear seats, I decided I wanted to use pretty much all of them because I love that look. So these are the rear seats that will mount inside, right like so, and like so. So those are going to be mounted inside there on either side, of course, on their appropriate sides when we mold it around there. That'll be there. This rear seat will be assembled back here like so. That will sit back there. And then those three cushier seats you'll see will be across the front. This is more for safaris. They can get a lot of people in the vehicle and cruise them around. So we've got all those sub-assemblies. You can see that nice rear seat goes together. We'll get that all painted up. They want that all one color, in the manual at least. Same with these back seats. And then if we want to pick out the frame on these back seats, we can go ahead and do so. The interior panels are easy to work on. We do nothing here. It'll all be accomplished after primer with some masking. On the rear door, I did glue in the handle to make sure it was on there securely with model glue, and that is all you need to do for that panel as well. We'll be painting those body color and then picking out the door panels. This is our grille, our mirrors, our headlight inserts. To begin with, they'll all be black. Then we can cut off small sections and do our grille up in a metallic. And then finally, we got our wheels. I did glue the wheel backs in to stick them on. I don't want to play with this. I don't want it to roll off the shelf either. So I do glue mine in solidly. The tires are solid rubber. I do not recommend gluing the wheels and tires together until after you get this painted. Then you probably can just press fit it into the tire. We'll find out and I'll let you know. So I don't recommend gluing those together or you're going to have a heck of time getting those solid tires over it. I'm going to take all these parts, head over to the paint area. We're going to go through a lot of primer on this stuff. Then we're going to pick out the body color I want to use and get to that. We'll see you over there. all kinds of work done since we last saw you in the painting section. We're doing work. I've also gone through, just so you know, in case I forget to mention it, and I've shot a flat semi-gloss coat on the body to tone down the paint. You can see it's not really glossy anymore. It's glossy in some sections like it should be, but I kind of just misted a dull coat over it. Did the same with the hood. See that kind of mottled effect on there? That's what I like. That's what I was going for. So, painting small details, you saw me do the gloss coat on the seats. Now, if you do a second gloss coat, you'll get a stronger vinyl look. I wanted kind of a, I don't know what you'd call it, naugahyde, vinyl imitation leather, whatever it would be. I didn't want it to be super glossy, and I didn't want it to be completely flat like the seats next to it. I wanted it to be in between, so I just did one light coat. Then I did like the cables and hoses. We all saw that in that video. Here we go with the door panels that have been masked off, the rear panel, the tailgate, the other door panel. You saw how nice that came out. We just have to do some detailing on that. We've got our dashboard done up with that simple, very light coat of gloss coat. Keep adding more when you want a shinier coat. If you want it a little bit shinier, see how I double coated the battery and it's come out shinier for me. That's the look I'm going for on that. I hand painted the interior. I didn't mask it out. I wanted a little more rough texture, more like a rubber mat. So I did the hand brushing, which gives me very fine brush lines in there. So that is a rubber coated mat down there. I did the steering wheel up, but left the drive shafts alone. I painted the bottom of the springs like they ask you to do on the frame. Now we'll go ahead, we'll start dry brushing. I did the headlight bezels. They wanted them black on the back, silver on the front, so I did it that way. And I glossed up the mirrors. The radiator shroud here, the grill. I'm going to dry brush that fine mesh with a very light coat of metallic and then leave it alone so it looks like it's got that mesh over a darker background. We'll be all set with that. These rear seats look awesome. Can't wait to throw those in. We've got our exhaust all painted up. Got to rust that out. We're not doing a destroyed vehicle. I almost never do those, but I do want to do it used, well used, like a Safari or what I call Crocodile Dundee's town car. His International in the movie, I wish they made a model of that International. I'd do it up. This is what he takes to town with his girlfriend, you know, when he doesn't want to go walk about, he wants to go drive about. Got the engine painted. That's ready to be dropped in and dirtied up a little bit. Used Tester silver accents, used Kraft black paint, used a burnt sienna to rust out the manifold. When you do that, I don't know if it'll show up in camera, but brush lightly and you'll still get some of the metal tones that I did the engine in. The book says pretty much it's a metallic tone on the engine, so that's what I did. I used that charcoal metallic and then hand painted everything else. We just got to put the belts and pulleys on there, get that sunbeam covered in oils and dirtiness and a little dust, and that's ready to be dropped into the chassis with the drive shafts. Weather the chassis up. I'm going to go ahead, bolt up that interior. Look how nice this is going to go together. Slide that in there. Oh, blah, blah, baby. That's going to end up pressing in right into those tabs. Of course, doing it in one hand. And it goes down farther into there. You can see the hole. There we go. It'll all line up, and that's not even glued or doing, it's just doing it on camera. And you see the different tone between the floor mats and the door using two different types of black. That's what I'm going for. Got to weather that interior up a little bit. Not too bad, but just a little bit. And we'll be ready to go. When I get that interior bolted onto the frame, get the engine bolted in, we will come back for a look-see. You've seen me do dry brushing in numerous episodes. It's my preferred method of weathering, and I love using craft paints. Now, I wanted to fade the paint of this lovely Range Rover because I can't rust the body panels, which is a bummer, but hey, we can fade them. You see that variation over the sage green, all over the vehicle. We got more on the hood, flatting it out. We got it on the sides. We got where dirt would collect in the door handles and run down. I've got where dirt would collect around the mounts for the roof rack, which is going on last. We got dirt around each individual little window on the top. We dirtied the wheel up a little bit and the tire to dust it up, but I didn't rust that out or anything. It's pretty much never been used up there. We got dirt in the windows and then rubbed out. The windows on cars usually that are used aren't so filthy you can't see through them. We dirtied up the back where dust is going to kick up and swirl around. I attached all of our lights. I did some dirt around the grill and around the front bumper where it's going to kick up, and around our wheel wells and anywhere where dirt can kind of sit and then slowly run off the body is what I did all the way around the sides, the back windows, all that kind of stuff. Now, when I'm all done, each individual window frame, I'm going to use my silver gel pen to go ahead and highlight those. So you'll see them highlighted with a little bit of metallic in the end. But I wanted to wait till the very end to do that. I've also weathered the entire interior. Now the dashboard mounts up underneath the body, so I didn't want to put that on yet. I wanted you to be able to see it. Very plain dashboard, three decals, two for the gauges, one for the center area, and then dustied it up a little bit with some dry brushing, dusted up the underhood area where we got our air box and our master cylinder and our steering column and stuff like that, how they want you to. That actually does not mount on the interior. It mounts in these grooves underneath the body. That's where it will glue in. So that's where that's going to go before we're all done. Did dry brushing and washing. I used a nice Tamiya accent color brown after I brushed in some rust and crust. Now the tires I'm going to put on the rear, I did a heavier rust because they catch more back there. The ones on the front, I was a little lighter because all they really have is from steering and stuff, so it's not a big deal. Over here are all the little parts I have to put on when we're all done under the hood, and parts I don't want to break off. Radio antenna, you don't want to put that on till the end. Mirrors, I'm going to be using these square mirrors on the side mounts where I had already drilled the holes. I did dirty them, but I don't want to put them on till the end. This goes on under the hood once the body is on, the reservoir tank. Same with the engine air cleaner. So I did dust it up a little bit. Battery, this is the spare tire mount. They give you a spare one. The battery will be going underneath there, so I did dusty it up. We got whatever this is. It goes under the hood. I don't know what it is. We got our hood prop rod. I'll never end up using this, but that's what that is on there. So we're going to be working on that. I've got the wheels dirtied up. You can see if you pack paint into the tread, just pack it in with your brush. Jab it in there real hard. Make sure you dirty the back of your wheels as well. If you jam it in and then rub your tires and tread, it comes off in a beautiful, realistic pattern. And you get more mud in some tires, more dust underneath the tread than you would. Make sure your tread's usually pretty clean unless it's in a diorama, because the minute it hits the road, it wears off. Then using different colors of craft paints like gray, brown iron oxide, I dirtied up the floor mats, seats. What I did with the seats to make them look like faded vinyl was I dry brushed them with a very light coat of the gray. Did our shift levers, one in yellow, one in red for the transfer cases, and then our shifter is black and our emergency brake is black. We've got our engine inside that chassis, just did the same dust and dirt effects with dry brushing, and I really rusted up the exhaust underneath here by stippling, which is stippling is just taking a brush and dabbing paint on really thick in my case, so that it's kind of clunky and chunky, and I would use paints like burnt sienna, brown iron oxide, and a little metallic to go in there, and you can see where it's rusted up and crusted up. And we got our whole underbody dry brushed and highlighted, and then I took straight paint and again stippled it and packed it up into the fenders, especially in the rear and good amount in the front because it is four-wheel drive. But yeah, so we got that all dirtied up and beat up. We got the interior a little dirty, not completely used up. The interiors don't get half as dirty as you think you would. Even on a vehicle that goes off-roading and is quite old, they're just pretty much dusty and a little scuffed up, like I have the seats in there, a little lightened up from being rubbed on and dust on and stuff. So what I will be doing at this point is getting the body on the chassis, and it should just drop straight on down for me. According to the manual, there isn't any positive lock or weird systems on there. Then Once I get that, we'll attach our roof rack, our wheels. Oh, look how nice these wheels go on. Big center holes, big axle tabs, and you just turn them and push them in, and bang, zoom, your wheels are on. You're not going to break anything. You're not going to crack anything pushing those on. Great design, strong design. We're going to get that body on. I've got to put the roof rack on. That's the last thing I wanted to do. The roof rack is silver, so I'm guessing it's aluminum or stainless, so I'm not going to rust or crust that at all. And that would stay pretty darn clean every time it got rained up there anyways. Just a little bit of dirt would collect around the mounts and generally on the roof where it couldn't get washed off by rain and stuff and walked on and stood on when they put stuff on the roof rack. So I will get it buttoned up. There's only a couple decals left to go, like the Land Rover on the grill and stuff like that, license plates, couple underhood decals. We'll get those on. We'll make sure that those have a little dirt over them, and we'll be back for the final. Revell's brand new Land Rover long wheelbase series 3 is all done. 1/24th scale, 184 awesome detailed parts, brings you this gorgeous kit, brand new mold, brand new for 2019. Give you folks a chance to watch this right after Christmas while the family's arguing about politics. You get to check out a cool new model from Revell. This is on pre-order at Model Roundup. I want you to go over there. There'll be a link in the description to get this and get it on pre-order, so when it hits the shores for you, you will be able to pick it up and build it up. Now, I went with a faded paint scheme. I love how that works out. I showed you the craft paints. You just pick a couple shades lighter and start dry brushing it, and you'll get that weather checked, that chalky oxidized paint look. You can build this left or right hand drive. You've got all kinds of options in this awesome kit, and you don't have to worry about not having the parts you want. If you want to build it as a British or a German or whatever, right and left hand drive, you are all set with this kit. All the parts you need are in there. Awesomely detailed engine and driveline. They didn't leave any details overlooked. It's not a curbside like a lot of European kits. This is a full interior, full engine, full drivetrain, and gorgeous. Just gave it some light weathering. I didn't want to destroy it. When it comes around up here on the roof on the driver's side, where I figure they'd be throwing a lot of stuff or yanking it off or going up on the roof, I did rub the paint right down to the bare metal. What I just did was rub some silver paint when I was all done, and it looks like they've rubbed it down to the bare metal on top of the roof from dragging things up and down, because this is the side, of course, that the driver, since I did the right-hand drive, would be getting out of the mold, so he's going to be using that side all the time. You can see where I kind of rubbed it off, but the glass, by the way, all press fits in all the way around, even the upper glass, even the glass on the roof, the little skylights, the little vents up there, that all just presses in. No glue has been used to hold those in place, so you don't have to worry about that either when you build yours. I gave it a little bit of dirt around the seams of each window just to dust it up, and a little bit of the windshield, but this is driven every day. They're going to keep it up. I love the kit. I'm glad I got a hold of it, and you can too. Follow those easy weathering tips for a cool-looking model, and we will see you at the next review.